Let me tell you, this is the Care Wow segment, and this is a class from Longview, Texas. They went viral singing, yes, Como La Flor. What, how many views?
9.9 million views on TikTok. Teacher Elizabeth Coti uses Selena's songs to teach Spanish. What a wonderful way to teach Spanish. You know, more than 25 years later, Selena's impact is still being felt. She sold more than 30 million records and continues to be referred as the queen of Tejano music.
Because she is.
Because she is.
That she is. That is for sure, and continues to represent Tejano music around the world. When you talk about Tejano, it is, of course, synonymous with the name Selena. And
absolutely.
Selena is synonymous with the name Corpus Christi, with the community of Corpus Christi.
And
we love
music,
her and her music.
Of course, and her music's so classic. It doesn't matter how many years pass, you can still play her music, and it's still...
Timeless.
Timeless.
Absolutely timeless.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I remember when I was working for KCB, I couldn't remember a day when Selena was not, you know, requested.
Yeah.
All the years that I worked for KCB, about 20 plus years,
yeah,
every day there was always requests for her, no matter what.
And I tell you what, this is a segment here where we wanted to talk about our memories.
Yes.
In 1986, me ofrecieron trabajo con la cadena de ABC Television in California. And before I left, I was over at the other station, at Channel 6. I was anchoring the news over there, and Mr. Q and I had talked. And I said, look, I'm going to be driving to California, and I hope to run into you guys again cuando esté in California, in San Francisco, Los Angeles, and Fresno.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you what, before I left, Mr. Q came over to the station and dropped off a bunch of cassettes along with a picture with Selena, from Selena, and I was wondering if Iris... I was able to put that up there so we could show it. I don't know if she has it up there, but she sent over a personalized picture, brought it over. There it is right there with Selena and the Dinos, and she sent that and autographed it to me, and I have forever kept that as part of my treasure trove of Selena. Yes, let me tell you, that's not going anywhere right there. That is so important to me and so special because she wrote it to me. And those are the memories that we have, just like you have the memories of KCB and playing her music.
You know, even before KCB, I remember, I can't remember how old I was, but I did get to see her perform one time here in Corpus Christi. And I remember as soon as she went on that stage, it was such an impacting moment because you couldn't keep your eyes off her. I mean, her beautiful smile and everything in the talent, I was a fan from then on.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I was sharing this with Iris when my daughter was maybe one. She was on her little bouncer. The Selena movie came on.
Mira.
Look at her.
Mira.
And ever since then, she's been a fan. My daughter absolutely loved Selena. Had us take her to L.A. to go look for her. Oh, this is the very first time she visited the museum. She wanted to take a picture with every outfit. Then she heard Suzette's voice. Mira. And I said, no, don't bother me. She's working allá. Corriendo, porque she knew, Selena's sister. You know, that was her first time visiting the museum. She made us take her all the way to L.A. to take a picture. She wanted to look for her star. We did that. We also were there for the unveiling of the wax figure.
Mm-hmm. In L.A.?
In L.A., yeah. My daughter was maybe one or two at that age. I mean,
I was there this past, this past fall? When I went to L.A. and my daughter and I went over and we saw the statue, but the thing is, there was a line of people still wanting to see that even today, and it's been there for how many years now? There's still a line to see Selena's statue in Los Angeles, so it's crazy. But let me tell you, it is amazing.
There's a picture of me and you when they did the Mac makeup here in Corpus Christi.
Oh my goodness!
There's my daughter with a star. There's the family up there on the far left there at the unveiling of the wax figure.
That's just amazing, right?
Do you remember that picture?
Yes, I do remember.
Wait,
my goodness!
I have to run the makeup.
I like to see. Nombre todos ahí enfrente de line. We got in there and just enjoyed it.
I still haven't used it. I have it put away for my daughter.
Absolutely.
All
we can understand.
Isn't that amazing?
It sure is.
It's just amazing. I was talking also to her director, Blake, how, you know, she impacts children that aren't really sure of who she is. You saw my daughter wasn't even one, and she was just going crazy over her music.
Yeah.
That impact that she still has, and she will continue to have.
Absolutely.
Oh, it's amazing.
You know, that life and legacy will live on through her music, the personality, and the personal stories that are shared, because those of us who are lucky enough to have been touched by her in one way or another can pass those stories on, and that legacy will continue. Mm-hmm. Like through her music that you're about to see here in another video, Celine Dodino's No Debes Jugar, right here on Domingo Live.
Yo no soy ningún mujer, amigo, esto no es un slow, que yo no estoy para servirte. Se me da una fácil, con mi amor siempre jugar, pero muy pronto yo te pongo en tu lugar. No debes jugar con mi amor. No debes dudar con mi cariño. Si te quieres o no, ya dímelo. Para seguir yo mi camino. Cariño. Le das cuerda cuando quieres. Amigo, esto no es justo, que ya no estoy para servir.